Can I trust you?
Of course.
The formidable global spy agency, Citadel, has met its downfall, resulting in the complete erasure of its agents' memories. Emerging from the void left by Citadel's demise is the rising force known as Manticore, a powerful syndicate. Now faced with the challenge of rediscovering their own pasts, the former agents of Citadel must muster the strength and determination necessary to launch a counteroffensive against Manticore.
I brought you here because I need your help.
I coached Little Lee.
There's my guy. Right now, every agent around the world is looking for you two.
Nadia.
Perdone, I think you're the wrong person.
You should have stayed dead.
You're gonna wish I was dead.
You remember?
I remember everything.
The Last of Us is an American post-apocalyptic drama television series created by Craig Mazin and Neil Druckmann for HBO. Based on the 2013 video game developed by Naughty Dog, the series is set in 2023, 20 years into a pandemic caused by a mass fungal infection, which causes its hosts to transform into zombie-like creatures and collapses society. The series follows Joel, Pedro Pascal, a smuggler tasked with escorting the immune teenager Ellie, Bella Ramsey, across a post-apocalyptic United States.
It can't be for nothing. There's no halfway with this. We finish what we started.
Our people are scattered. Like stars in the galaxy.
The ongoing adventures of the Mandalorian within the expansive Star Wars galaxy persist. Din Djarin, who was once a solitary bounty hunter, has successfully reunited with Grogu. Concurrently, the New Republic faces challenges in guiding the galaxy towards a brighter future, attempting to distance itself from a shadowy past. Throughout their shared journey, the Mandalorian will encounter familiar allies and encounter unfamiliar adversaries as he and Grogu forge ahead together.
I'm going to Mandalore so that I may be forgiven for my transgressions.
May the Force be with you!
This is the way.
Now here's a funky introduction to how nice I am. Tell your mother, tell your father, send a telegram. I'm like an energizer. Oh!
Are you okay?
Okay.
The world of the power is our world, but for one twist of nature. Suddenly, and without warning, all teenage girls in the world develop the power to electrocute people at will. It's hereditary, it's inbuilt, and it can't be taken away from them. Coming alive to the thrill of pure power, the ability to hurt or even kill by releasing electrical jolts from their fingertips, they rapidly learn they can awaken the power in older women. Soon enough, nearly every woman in the world can do it.
But it's hundreds and thousands.
I'm a journalist. I want to tell your story. It's gonna change things.
What did you do?
The world as we know it may never be the same.
Delivery on 30?
Yeah, sign in.
Sure, you might hold on to that for me, thanks.
That is a bomb. I have just armed it. Don't move. You move, the bomb detonates. If I hear any alarms or sirens, I detonate the bomb, understand?
Skilled in the art of deception and adept at wreaking havoc on others' lives, John Weir operates as a corporate spy. However, during his latest assignment, an enigmatic cabal cunningly manipulates the situation, exacting retribution by falsely implicating him in a murder. Suddenly thrust into a perilous cat-and-mouse pursuit, John must navigate the treacherous game in order to reclaim his freedom.
You think you're shopping for socks, but they know who you're voting for.
Why me?
I can trust you.
You're the one who taught me not to trust anybody.
Corporate espionage is the dirty way to get rich.
Are you accusing me of something?
The
The FBI is the United States' premier law enforcement agency.
Ma'am, I need to take my seat.
Peter Sutherland, a low-level FBI agent stationed in the White House basement, spends his days tending to a silent phone that rarely springs to life. However, one fateful night, the unexpected happens. The phone rings, thrusting him into a web of intrigue that unravels a far-reaching conspiracy, ultimately reaching the highest seat of power in the Oval Office.
Welcome to the White House, Peter.
Have you ever heard of Night Action? It's a top-secret investigative program within the FBI.
So you want me to be a night agent?
God, no. I want you to answer the phone for them. It rarely rings.
Yes, go ahead.
I'm in danger. There's intruders. What do I do?
It's gonna be all right.
I'm on my way.
10 million, as agreed.
I'll need to confirm the funds.
The narrative revolves around Charlie, a skilled swindler burdened by a debt owed to the notorious crime boss Daphne Finch. Adding to the intrigue, Emma, an undercover CIA officer, is diligently pursuing Daphne. As fate would have it, a single night of intense passion ignites a profound love between Charlie and Emma, who find themselves on a collision course both personally and professionally.
Vodka martini, extra dirty. Relationships. What a racket.
A shell game to conceal who you really are.
So, what do you do?
I'm a yoga instructor. You?
I'm a pageant queen turned rocket scientist.
Well, I bet those pageants really prepared you for NASA, though.
Now tell me something true.
I'm a criminal.
I'm CIA.
The series revolves around the life of a young orphan and skilled cartographer named Alina Starkov, who serves in the Ravka Nation's First Army. Unexpectedly, she discovers that she possesses extraordinary powers as a Grisha, someone endowed with unique abilities and destined to fulfill a crucial role in the universe's time of great need.
Hurricane.
The Darkling has created an unkillable army made of shadow.
Kerrigan, down this country.
You must find the Firebird. And the Sea Whip. Take their power. Finish what you started.
We do not know why we are here. We do not know who built the silo.
Set in a dystopian future plagued by devastation and toxicity, the highly anticipated TV series Silo makes its debut on Apple TV Plus on May 5. Within the depths of a colossal underground silo, thousands of individuals have sought refuge. However, when the sheriff of this secluded community violates a crucial principle, leading to the mysterious deaths of its inhabitants, engineer Juliet, portrayed by Rebecca Ferguson, embarks on a relentless quest to unveil the startling secret.
Nicole. There's always someone who has a theory about the silo. I need to find out the truth.
In 2071, extreme air pollution has turned the majority of the Korean peninsula into a wasteland after a comet wiped out all but 1% of its original population, who live in segregated districts based on their social status. They are also required to wear respirators and rely on the nights, specialized delivery drivers, to provide them with the supplies, especially fresh oxygen, they need to stay alive.
여긴 어디야?
이 모든 게 천명이 만든 세상입니다.